स्पीड एंड वेलोसिटी. दिस इज द नायर फैमिली एंड दे आर प्लानिंग टू ट्रेवल टू केरला. द नायर फैमिली इज ट्रेवलिंग फ्रॉम मुंबई टू केरला. लेट्स से that the distance between Mumbai and Kerala is 1600 kilometers. Now when they think of traveling, they have three travel options before them. They can travel by plane, train or by bus. If the family thinks of traveling by plane, then the plane takes 2 hours to reach Kerala from Mumbai. The train takes 26 hours, whereas the bus takes 48 hours to reach Kerala. So for the same distance, what is the distance? 1600 kilometers. You can see the you can compare the time. If the fastness of the means of travel is more, the time taken is less, isn't it? For example, if the plane travels very fast, so the time taken by the plane is less. Fastness is more, time is less. But if the fastness is less, the time becomes more. For example, if you look at the bus takes 48 hours. That is, the time is more because the fastness is less. Okay. So, here we can see that fastness is inversely proportional to time. As fastness increases, time decreases. And as fastness decreases, time increases. So, fastness is inversely proportional to time. Now, let's keep the distance time constant. So, if we keep the time constant, let's say after 1 hour, say the plane is in Mangalore after 1 hour. After 1 hour, the train is in Panvel. Whereas after 1 hour, the bus is still in Mumbai. So, here we can see that if the fastness increases, the distance traveled by the means of transport is also more, isn't it? Because see, fastness, plane is more faster. So, the distance traveled by the plane is more. It is almost in Karnataka. So, fastness increases, then distance also increases. But if fastness decreases, that is, if you look at the bus, the distance will also decrease. The bus is still in Mumbai. So, what do we see here? Fastness is more, distance is more. Fastness is less, distance is less. So, what is this kind of variation called as? Direct variation. So, fastness is directly proportional to distance, isn't it? So, now if I compare these two equations, fastness is directly proportional to distance, but it is inversely proportional to time. So, the measure of fastness or slowness of motion is called as speed. How do we define speed? Speed is defined as distance covered by a body in unit time. So, formula of speed is equal to distance traveled divided by time taken. Now, since distance is a scalar quantity as well as time is a scalar quantity, speed is also a scalar quantity. So, speed requires only magnitude and no direction. Also, speed is the distance that is covered by an object. So, speed can never be negative. Now, in one of the slides, we have already studied what is uniform motion and non-uniform motion. In uniform motion, we have studied that an object covers equal distance in equal intervals of time. And in non-uniform motion, we have studied that an object covers unequal distance in equal intervals of time. So, uniform motion is also called as uniform speed or constant speed. Whenever a body covers equal distance in equal intervals of time, we say that the speed is uniform. Whereas, when a body covers unequal distance in equal intervals of time, then the speed is called as non-uniform, and non-uniform speed is also called as variable speed. Speed can be measured in kilometers per hour, miles per hour, meter per second, centimeter per second. In MK system, the unit of speed is meters per second. Why? Distance is travelled in meters and time is measured in seconds. So, meters upon seconds, that becomes meters per second. So, in SI system, in MK system or SI system, the unit of speed is meters per second. Whereas in CG system, distance is travelled in centimeters upon time is measured in seconds. Therefore, the unit of speed in the CG system is centimeters per second. So, we can define average speed of a body as, the average speed of a body is defined as the total distance travelled divided by the total time taken to cover the distance. So formula of average speed is total distance traveled upon total time taken. So once again, the units of speed are in SI system. The unit of speed is meters per second, because distance is measured in meters and time is measured in seconds. So the unit is meters per second, which is written as m per s or m slash s. In CGS system, distance is measured in centimeters upon time is measured in seconds. So in CGS system, the unit of speed is centimeter per second, which is written as centimeter per, that is slash second. Now we know that displacement is related with distance. So also there is another physical quantity which is related with speed. So speed tells us how fast or how slow an object is moving. So along with this, if we include direction along with speed, so speed with direction is called as velocity. Okay, so whenever we include the direction of motion with speed, we are talking of a new physical quantity which is called as velocity. So velocity is nothing but speed with direction. Now when we define velocity, we consider the change in displacement of an object with respect to time. So see, velocity is change in displacement, that is displacement. We are saying it is rate of change of displacement. So whenever we talk about rate, we always calculate any physical quantity with respect to time. So rate means it will be always divided by time. So velocity is rate of change of displacement. So velocity is displacement divided by time. Now, since velocity is displacement upon time, we know that displacement is a vector quantity. So, velocity is also a vector quantity. So, velocity requires both magnitude as well as direction. So, velocity is a vector quantity. Now, the unit of velocity is same as that of speed. Okay. What is the SI unit of displacement? Meter. Upon. What is the SI unit of time? Second. So, in SI system, the unit of velocity will be same as that of speed, meters per second. What is the unit of velocity in CGS? What is the unit of displacement in CGS system? Centimeter upon. Unit of time in the CGS system? Second. So, the unit of velocity in the CGS system will be centimeter per second. Now, velocity of an object can be positive, negative, or it can be zero as well. Sachin is traveling on a motorbike. Explain. What will happen in the following events? What will be the effect on the velocity of the motorcycle if Sachin is increasing or decreasing the speed of the motorcycle but keeping the direction unchanged? So let's say that Sachin is moving in one particular direction, that is the linear direction, the forward direction, and Sachin increases the speed of the motorbike. So when Sachin will increase the speed, if Sachin is increasing the speed, that means velocity is also going to increase, isn't it? If Sachin is decreasing the speed of the motorbike, the velocity of the bike will decrease. So, what will be the effect of velocity on the motorbike if the speed increases or decreases but the direction is constant? In that case, the velocity of the motorcycle will change. Now, suppose there is a turn, okay? And if Sachin changes the direction of the motorcycle. So, when Sachin changes the direction of the motorcycle, then and he keeps the speed constant, he is moving with uniform speed, then what will be the effect on velocity? So by changing the direction as well, the velocity of the object changes. If on turning, Sachin changes both the direction as well as the speed, so will it affect the velocity? Yes. When the direction changes, when the speed changes, the velocity also changes. So whenever speed is same but direction is changing, velocity changes. When direction is same but speed changes, still the velocity changes. If both speed and direction changes, still the velocity of an object changes. Now, as velocity is related to both speed and direction, we can change velocity. How? By changing the speed and keeping the direction constant, by changing the direction and keeping the speed constant, or by changing both speed as well as direction of motion of the object. Let's take up a textual activity. Amar, Akbar and Anthony are traveling in different cars with different velocities. And the distances that are covered by them during different time intervals are given in the tabular form. So the time is given where Amar Akbar and Anthony are traveling at the same time. They are starting at 5 o'clock, and the distance is recorded after every half an hour. So 5:36, 6:37. So you can see the time interval is equal, isn't it? So we are recording distance after equal intervals of time. So now let us see the distance that is covered by Amar in kilometers. So at 5 o'clock, the car was at rest. So the distance covered will be is equal to 0 kilometers. Okay. Now after half an hour, that is at 5:30, the distance covered is 20 kilometers. After half an hour, 40, 60, 80. So see what is the difference between the consecutive distances? 20 minus 0, 20. 40 minus 20, 20. 60 minus 40, 20. What is this kind of speed called as when a body covers equal distance in equal intervals of time? Uniform speed. That means Amar is moving with uniform speed. Okay. Let's see the distance that is covered by Akbar. So at 5 o'clock, Akbar covers 0 kilometers. After half an hour, Akbar covers a distance of 18 kilometers. Another half an hour, 36 kilometers. After another half an hour, 42 kilometers. So take the difference between two consecutive distances. 18 minus 0 will be 18. 36 minus 18 will be once again 18. 42 minus 36 will be 12. Isn't it? So here you can see that the distances are not equal, isn't it? Unequal distances are covered, but in equal intervals of time. That means Akbar is moving with non-uniform speed. Let's see Anthony. Anthony is at rest. The car is at rest. So the car covers 0 kilometers at 5 o'clock. After half an hour, the car covers 14 kilometers. After at 6 o'clock, the car has covered 28 kilometers. At 6:30, the car has covered 42 kilometers. At 7:56, so see 0, 14, 2 is 28, 14, 3 is 42, 14, 4 is 56, 14, 5 is 70, 14, 6 is 84. So you can see that the distance between two consecutive distances is equal. 14 minus 0, 14, 28 minus 14, 14, 42 minus 28, 14, 56 minus 42, 14. Here Anthony has covered equal distances in equal intervals of time, so his speed is uniform speed, isn't it? So Amar's car is moving at uniform speed, Anthony's car is moving with uniform speed, but Akbar's car is moving with non-uniform speed. So now let us see the questions. What is the time interval between the notings of distances made by Amar, Akbar and Anthony? What is the time interval? The time interval is of half an hour. Isn't it? The time gap is of half an hour. So what is answer? What is the time interval between the notings of distances made by Amar, Akbar and Anthony? Half an hour. Who has covered equal distances in equal intervals of time? Amar and Anthony. Are the distances covered by Akbar in the fixed time intervals the same? Has Akbar covered equal distance in equal intervals of time? No. So the distances covered by Akbar in fixed intervals of time is not the same. Fourth question. Considering the distances covered by Amar, Akbar and Anthony in fixed time intervals, what can you say about their speeds? We can say that Amar and Anthony are moving with uniform speed, but Akbar is moving with non-uniform speed. Why? Because Amar and Anthony are covering equal distances in equal intervals of time, so their speed will be uniform speed, whereas Akbar is covering unequal distance in equal intervals of time, so the speed will be called as non-uniform speed or variable speed.